Some of you watching may know that I'm not the biggest fan of RPGs, and you know what kind of RPG I'm talking about. Come on, man, read the room. I'm talking about traditional JRPGs. I get tired of turn-based combat very easily, and while I definitely appreciate a good story, it's far from the primary reason I play most video games. Beyond that, I find the core gameplay loop of fighting a bunch of little dudes until you've accumulated enough numbers to take down the boss immensely unsatisfying. Most victories in RPGs feel hollow, and losses can be particularly frustrating if you feel you just aren't a high enough level to take on the challenge. However, there are still a few RPGs that I really enjoy despite not being a fan of their gameplay, and as I'm sure you've deduced, Super Mario RPG is among them. While the gameplay of Super Mario RPG is mostly standard, there are a few notable deviations from the classic RPG formula. Most notable is the inclusion of timed hits and timed guards. All attacks can do extra damage with a timed A button press at a certain point in the animation. There's a reasonably lenient window for a partial critical, and a stricter, often 7-frame window for a full critical. You can also guard against an enemy's attack with a timed A button press. Again, it's pretty easy to get a weak guard for reduced damage, while a full guard for no damage has a strict 5-frame window. I'm a big fan of timed hits in RPGs. They help make the often boring turn-based battles more engaging, and for that reason, I do like the timing system in Super Mario RPG, but it could definitely have been implemented better. Some of you may be wondering why I was mentioning frame data earlier, or why I even know it at all, and that's just because most of the timed hits make absolutely no goddamn sense. For example, take a look at the animation for an attack with the knock-knock shell. When do you think you're supposed to press the button? Here, right when Mario kicks the shell? Or maybe here, when it actually hits the enemy? The animation has two clear points of impact, two reasonable visual cues for the proper timing of your attack. So, when are you actually supposed to press the button? From here to about here. Significantly before the actual point of impact. Many attacks are like this. The actual window for a timed hit is significantly earlier than any visual cue. It feels completely arbitrary, and I probably would never have understood the proper timing if I hadn't looked it up and found a frame data library intended to be used by speedrunners. I'll put a link in the description to the resource I used. I suggest you take a look at it if you have the time. You'll see just how weird the timing can be. Now, to be fair, not every attack is like this, but enough of them are that I felt I needed to bring it up. However, despite my issues with the actual timing of timed hits, I still see them as a positive. They make battles a lot more fun than they would have been without them. Super Mario RPG also made some changes to traditional RPG overworld gameplay. There are no random encounters, which instantly makes a game more fun, because you can at least see the enemies coming, and you have a chance to dodge encounters if you're skilled enough. Unfortunately, there's absolutely no invincibility frames after you finish a battle, so you'll sometimes have no chance to dodge the next one, which is naturally very annoying. There's also a lot of platforming. It is a Mario RPG after all, but I sometimes wish there wasn't. Depth perception was a constant issue due to the game's isometric visuals, making platforming shockingly difficult. There are also hidden chests throughout the game, similar to hidden blocks in the mainline Mario titles. I think I found like two of them in the entire game. These things were either very well hidden or completely arbitrarily placed. I'm probably just a moron who couldn't recognize clear hidden chest locations, I'm not denying that. But I'm still not a big fan of these secrets, even in concept. Alright, I know I just did that fun and quirky thing where I say I like a game and then proceed to shit all over it for the rest of the video. It's clear to me that in past reviews, I've been overly critical of games I like in an attempt to seem unbiased. But for Super Mario RPG, that's not the case. I just actually hate the gameplay. So, the reasonable response to that is, how can you say you like a game if you hate arguably the most important aspect of it? And you have a point, but this game has a lot of other strengths, like the fact that it's actually fucking hysterical. Super Mario RPG is definitely one of the funniest games I've ever played. Hell, it might even be number one. It made me laugh out loud multiple times, which is incredibly rare. The dialogue's great, there's a ton of good visual humor, and every part of the game is wacky and lighthearted. The entirety of the booster section is just hilarious, it's one great moment after another. There's a part where you sneak into a castle disguised as a statue called a Plumber's Lament. There's a tiny martial arts master who destroys your party through displays of overwhelming power. There's a moment where Frog Fuchsius, yes, Frog Fuchsius, tells Mellow he isn't actually a tadpole, and it plays a song simply titled Sad Song, and it sounds like this. This game is brilliant. Speaking of the music, the soundtrack is full of great songs. The battle themes are upbeat and fun, and even though you'll be listening to them for many, many hours, I never got tired of hearing them. Town themes can put a smile on anyone's face, and dungeon themes are often darker, yet still incredibly catchy. It's very likely you've heard at least one song from this game, because it seems everybody who's listened to it has fallen in love with it. It's fantastic. The music does a great job of contributing to the game's lighthearted atmosphere and making the experience constantly enjoyable. So, even though I'm not really a big fan of RPGs, Super Mario RPG sticks out in my head as a great experience and a game I'm glad I finally played. There's a lot to like if you can just get past the gameplay, and for people who do like RPGs, I can't imagine how you could possibly dislike this. It's exactly what a Mario RPG should be, and I look forward to hearing remixes of some of these great songs in Smash when they finally add Mallow.